Hi, welcome to Brief Brain Facts, where you bring your brain and we'll bring the facts. Amnesia and memory have been associated with a few key areas in the brain. And one of those areas associated with memory is the diencephalon, which, along with the hippocampus, is responsible for forming declarative memories. Those memories regarding facts and events. Regarding amnesia, there are two types. Anterograde amnesia, which is the inability to form new memories, and retrograde amnesia, which is the inability to recall old memories. One of the ways in which the diencephalon was found to be an important area for memory is from Korsakoff syndrome. Korsakoff syndrome is characterized by severe impairments in memory. There are 7 essential symptoms of Korsakoff syndrome: anterograde amnesia, retrograde amnesia, apathy, which is indifference to changes or loss of interests in things one once found interesting. But research suggests apathy experienced in Korsakoff's is associated with the inability to express oneself over the inability to actually experience emotions and interests. Anosognosia, or lacking insight into the severity of one's own illness, which is one reason people with mental illnesses such as schizophrenia fail to take their medications. Fixation amnesia, which is the inability to remember things that occurred only moments apart. Confabulation, or the invention of false memories, to fill in memory gaps that are associated with things like blackouts. And finally, difficulties in conversational abilities. Typically, Korsakoff syndrome results from chronic alcoholism, so much so that it's often called alcoholic Korsakoff syndrome, or AKS. Chronic alcoholism, combined with the toxicity of alcohol, can lead to a thiamine or vitamin B1 deficiency. It's this deficiency that can actually cause AKS. Luckily, a deficiency in thiamine is treatable, but if left untreated, the absence of thiamine can lead to permanent brain damage that won't respond to treatment. Unfortunately, only about 20% of people respond to this treatment once Korsakoff syndrome has taken effect. AKS occurs when one reaches the state of an untreatable thiamine deficiency that has led to lesions to the thalamus and the hypothalamus, both located in the diencephalon, as well as general cerebral atrophy, or a general but widespread loss of brain tissue, which of course could then lead to other intrusive symptoms that are not necessarily characteristic of AKS, but is the result from the general loss of brain matter. As mentioned, both anterograde and retrograde amnesia are symptoms of Korsakoff syndrome, but retrograde amnesia, the amnesia type associated with the ability to recall old memories, can be particularly severe. Interestingly, life expectancy in people with AKS is approximately normal, providing that they maintain a decent diet and stay away from alcohol. Korsakoff syndrome is a reminder that our brain is still susceptible to external insults, and what we put into our bodies actually does matter. If you liked what you watched, please subscribe to our channel and hit that thumbs up button. And as always, thank you for watching.